Welcome to the video homecoming, step 5 of the 4th innovation methodology. My name is Gijs van Wulven. I'm a global speaker on innovation, creativity and design thinking. And you're watching the YouTube channel Inspiration for Innovation, where I make practical how to do videos to make you a great innovator. I'm talking to you from the island of Crete, where I live, where we have beautiful weather. And as you can see, mountains and a beautiful view out on the sea. So there are 6 videos on the 4th innovation methodology. There's one which has an overview of all the 5 steps of the method. There's one for each step. So there's one on full steam ahead, one on observe and learn, one on raise ideas, one on test ideas. And today I will be talking to you about homecoming, the final phase of 4th. This video on homecoming, I will discuss 3 things. First of all is how to make a great business case for innovation. Second is how to get support at top management, who have to say yes, otherwise nothing happens. And the third thing is how to create the start of a culture for innovation within your organization. Now, stay to the end of the movie, because then I will tell you where you can download 20 checklists about this methodology and 13 maps. The map in 30 languages. In this video, you will also find pictures. Pictures of a real life 4th for Breuil. Breuil is a mid-sized company in the Netherlands. They work around 300 people and they make concrete. They did a 4th 5 years ago. And I will show you pictures of that 4th, of the homecoming, and what came out of 4th for them. Some really great evolutionary, but also revolutionary business cases. What is 4th? 4th is a structured innovation methodology combining business thinking with design thinking, back to business thinking. 2 great aspects of 4th are, first, that it connects customers to the process. You go out and observe and learn, trying to get customer insight from customers. You ideate great solutions and you go out again to customers on test ideas, checking if the solutions are spot on. The second great aspect is that you do not do this journey along with your innovation team. The decision makers are on board of the journey. So there is no steering committee. The steering committee is on board as extended team. The internal innovation team will spend 20 days on these 15-week expedition as of the kickoff. The extended team, the decision makers, will spend 6 days in 20 weeks to create wonderful new business cases. Information about the methodology you can find in this book, The Innovation Expedition. It is translated in 8 languages and you can get it on Amazon. The methodology is also scientifically researched by the Open University. 10 cases have been investigated, and Professor Herman van der Bos concluded that with 4th, out of the 4 mini business cases which enter your regular R&D process, 3 of them reach the market after development. So it's 3 out of 4. In normal innovation processes, Cooper and Edgett have researched that out of the 3 ideas, only 1 gets out the state gate process on the market. So with the 4th innovation methodology and the structured start of innovation, you more than double the effectiveness of your organization. What is 4th used for? Well, it can be anything as long as it's innovation. So it can be new products, new services, new business models, new customer experiences, new internal processes, or even the way you organize yourself. And then we get in the field of social innovation. The users are so diversified. They are all over the world. Small, medium-sized, and very big companies. Huntsman, one of the leaders in the chemical industry based in the US. They use the fourth innovation methodology on every continent to come up with new revolutionary solutions for their customers. Also in Asia, in Japan, NEC, NEC, a Japanese tech giant, has discovered forth to transform new technologies into workable solutions which solve customer frictions. It also has been used by the UNHCR in social innovation to make a refugee camp in Uganda a safer place for women and girls. And they won the UNHCR Prize of Excellence for that outstanding innovation project. But also used by government organizations or in healthcare. So it doesn't matter what your organization is fit for forth. Today, I'm going to talk about step number 5 of the forth methodology, homecoming. So we started here with an innovation assignment. We went out there, get our blinders off and observe and learn. We got great customer frictions. We selected the best ones and at our brainstorm here on Raise Ideas, we got more than 1,000 ideas, 50 idea directions, and we made 12 to 15 concepts. We have tested the concepts here at customers and then we improved them here in a second concept improvement workshop. And we have chosen 3, 4, or 5 business cases to work out on homecoming. Homecoming has 3 activities. First of all, we have 4 mini new business case workshops with the core team. Then we have the final presentation, the end presentation. And afterwards, on those business cases, which is decided that they will enter your R&D process, we will have a concept transfer workshop to really connect forth with your normal innovation process to make an implementation plan. So the deliverables of the fourth innovation method are, first of all, 3 to 4, 5 mini new business cases. It is an innovative mindset at the people joining the journey. And you have an effective innovation process implemented in your organization. In 4 mini new business case workshops, pairs of the innovation team will work each on 1 business case. So it's very simple. With an innovation team of 6, you can develop 3 business cases. 8, 4, and with 10 people, you can draft 5 mini new business cases. Why? In pairs, it works really good. You pair an R&D guy with a marketing lady, or you pair a saleswoman with a production guy. Right? In this way, you have a 360 capabilities and skill team there. That's why you work out business cases in pairs. Why business cases? Because management might ask, bring me new ideas. But what they are interested in is not the ideas. They're interested in, will it bring revenue? Will it bring contribution margin? Will it bring profits? Will it bring me new customers? So it's about the results. That's why it's great if you present an idea. It's great if you have a nice customer journey, or if you present personas who are customer groups, or even if you make a wonderful movie on the prototype. But be sure to accompany that with a good, solid business case. In the history of Forth, we made a wonderful, simple structure for the business case. As you can see, 6 steps, perhaps 10 to 15 slides. 1, what is the customer friction we are solving? 2, this is our new concept. 3, this is the benefit for the customer, because why should it change? 4, can we make it? Yes, we can. 5, this is what we get in terms of revenues, profits, customers, and this is the way we continue. If you say yes, management, it will mean that you will invest $200,000 in this project, and we will free 2 people to work 2 years, and we will do these and these and these and these activities. And these are the uncertainties we still have to check. Why? Because we're still at the front end of innovation. This business case doesn't give certainty. It gives a clear direction in which we want to move. And of course, during the R&D process, which might be an industrial company still 2, 3, or 4 years, these are the points which are really relevant. So we must investigate it. That's what a mini new business case is about. At the end presentation, we deliver 3, 4, or 5 business cases. Now, how do we get support? Well, remember we have the extended team and the core team. The extended team are the decision makers. In each final phase, we ask each of the extended team member to be godfather of one of the business cases. So the leadership team is connected to those business cases. It means that they will not be surprised at the end presentation, because they are kind of grandfather or grandmother of a business case. So this is how you build support. The leadership team has been on this journey. They discovered customer insights. They brainstormed with us. They have seen how customers responded, and they are godfather of a business case. And that's why in the end they support our findings, and they understand what we mean. There is trust that the business case will deliver, and this is how you get support. A few years ago, I added another workshop, the concept transfer workshop, because you must really connect at the end of this project into your normal procedures. And it will take 1 or 2 months to get an implementation team to take care of the innovation delivery of the project. And in a concept transfer workshop, people from the Forth team and the implementation team get together, and together they make the implementation plan. So you're sure that the spirit, the insights, and the deliverables of Forth are really well understood by the people who will implement the innovation delivery. In the end, Forth delivers great, good business cases. I told you the story of Brel. They brought back 5 mini new business cases. I'd like to give you 2 examples of business cases for Brel. One of them is evolutionary. It is the tiling glue silo. And the other one is revolutionary. It is 3D printing of concrete. The evolutionary one was developed within 1.5 years. And instead of delivering tiling glue in bags, which the tiler has to mix with water and then apply on the floor, they delivered the tiling glue in a silo where automatically the water came in, and there was an automatic mixer, and he could put in just his wheelbarrow below it and have ready to mix tiling glue on the floor. It saved him 1 person in the tiling glue team, and that's why tilers increased their profit with this tiling glue, and Brel has tripled their market share in the tiling glue for floors the last 4 years. Well done. The other one is really revolutionary. There was this dream of making beautiful concrete facades, but now in prefab concrete, for every specific facade, there must be made a mold, handmade, with wood, and you pour in the concrete and then you wait 2 weeks. Now, isn't it a bit crazy? Because the architects design in the computer, and then you go from 3D again to 2D. Hand job. Couldn't we automate this? And yes, they did. They worked more than 4 years on the 3D printing of concrete. And now they just opened the first 3D printing factory of architectonical concrete in the Netherlands. Congratulations, bro. And this is what it has done to the company. 5 years ago, it was in real, real trouble. And now it's one of the most innovative companies in the building sector in the Netherlands. Because that's what Ford did with them. Changed their mindsets. They saw opportunities again. And they did R and do. Not R&D, R and do. Because innovation only happens when you take action. So, this was the video about homecoming. Check the other phases. Check the other movies. A movie on full steam ahead. Observe and learn. Raise ideas and test ideas. I promise you 20 checklists to download. Where can you find them? Here! Ford-innovation.com. 20 checklists for you to download on this wonderful methodology and the map in 13 languages. Now, why should you use Ford? Well, of course you do me a pleasure. You use Forth because this really works, and I like to make you a great innovator. So I hope you like this movie. Please press thumbs up and subscribe. Click the red button and subscribe if you like to have more practical videos which makes you a better innovator. Thank you for your attention and stay safe.